who almost as many putters? I mean, have you ever looked for a putter? Have, you know, putter here, putter there? As many putters as there are personalities. And certainly, there is a putter for every type of personality. A putter that makes you feel good, makes you look good, makes you feel good. So we're taking a look at some of them, and we always do in the clubhouse. And we've featured Bettinardis. I've used a Bettinardi for a long time. From Axis Golf. I really like the feel of the Axis Club. Today, we're going to talk to Robbie Camacho, who is a fitter for the Yar putter. And I love the word, Yar. You know, you say, well, Yar, what's that, Yar? Well, if you're into sailing, you know that it means, it's a nautical term, and it means in a sailboat, for instance, quick and agile, easy to handle, reef and steer. And in fact, in 1940, Katharine Hepburn, I remember this, I can hear her voice, she goes, my, she was Yar. And she's talking about a sailboat that she and her husband are arguing about in the Philadelphia story. That's great. Mike Perkey, he's been on the show. He's a writer for Global Golf Post and former president of the Golf Writers of America Association. This is what he said about the Yar GX1. If tour players get hold of this putter, someone will threaten to shoot in the 50s almost every week. If you struggle with putting and think it must be black magic, putting for 5 minutes with the GX1 will cause you to abandon every other putter you've ever tried. Works for him. Okay. Steve Thomas, former Champions Tour player, scored back-to-back wins on the Florida Seniors Winter Tour. He was using the wide-body GX1WB. I haven't rolled the ball this well in years, he said. The Yar is saying, in my bag, people need to know about this putter. Now, this is also an interesting putter because it is ergonomically wonderful for people who have handicaps, challenges. You can't bend over, you know? It hurts. This putter is designed so you don't have to bend over and pick up your ball. It's amazing. And it has a huge sweet spot, but I go on. Welcome to the show, Robbie Camacho.
Hi, Danielle.
Hi, how are you in Tempe, Arizona?
I'm doing fine. Thank you for having me on your show.
Absolutely. Now, I was watching this great YouTube clip about Yar putters, and it was... Well, there was a voice that sounded an awful lot like a very famous actor. Was that him?
Well, he did a good portrayal of Jack Nicholson. He did very well.
It was very good. It was very good. But in this clip that you come on and talk actually, you know, seriously about Yar, he says that scientists at Yar are the same who stabilize aircraft going 2,000 miles an hour.
That is correct.
Can you explain that, please?
Well, when it comes to the putter, the scientists at Yar, when it comes to supersonic aircraft, it's the ability to have that object, being the aircraft, to stay stable at traveling at very high speeds.
One would hope, yes.
Yeah, well, exactly. So with the putter, what they've taken, the scientists at Yar have taken that technology and put their experiences through science and engineering in a putter to be stable, to be smooth when one swings the putter, to achieve the feeling of being smooth, having the putter being stable, therefore the outcome is rolling the ball smoothly, it hugs the ground, and the bottom line is people are starting to make more putts by using a Yar putter.
Okay. Now, isn't that what they pretty much said about the putter that's supposed to come back and be in the perfect position for you to strike the ball?
Well, with Yar, when you swing a Yar, whether you swing it normal, when I say normal, I'm talking back and forward, when you pick up a Yar, you can actually configure the club by swinging with the heel leading. You can swing with the toe leading. Of course, you wouldn't putt that way. But the reason why it works is no matter how you configure the Yar in your hands, it's going to be stable. Therefore, you can have a consistent, smooth, repeatable swing.
Okay, so that's what you're saying, that this club will come back and be square to the ball. The face, the club face will be square to the ball because it has such a large sweet spot.
Well, that's part of it. Part of it has to do with how you aim the face. So the feedback is phenomenal. When you swing in this putter and you hold your finish, you hold the end of your swing, where the face is exactly where the ball will end up.
Okay, when I've used it, I find it incredibly balanced. It feels in balance, and it's very light. Is that the
very balanced? Right. I mean, it's balanced. A lot of people will say, well, do you have anything heavier? And the answer is no. I mean, the putter is designed and engineered as is. Therefore, you don't need to add weight to it. You don't need to cut the shaft. I mean, when I do my fittings, of course, I'm fitting for line angle, I'm fitting for shaft. But when it comes to what people experience, most people feel that, wow, it's very light. It's easy to swing.
Yeah, and that for me, with the Bettinardi, it was always very heavy. You know, it's a heavy club, and I like the weight because I tend to be strong.
Right.
You know, and this is a very light. It's very light, but it's also much better on my back.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, there's so many benefits to the putter, not just the result of rolling the ball smoothly and seeing the ball go in the cup, but as you mentioned earlier, the putter's designed. You can actually put the entire putter head in the cup to retrieve your ball out of the cup when you make your putt.
No, that doesn't make any sense, does it, right now for you listening? You're saying to yourself, what is he talking about? Could this possibly be? Well, this putter, the head, has a opening in it so that you can literally put the club into the hole, and the ball will then get lifted up by the putter, and you can pull it up out of the hole and take it and walk away. You don't have to bend over. Shirley Spork was fitted during the Founders Cup, and she apparently likes this club a lot. Did you get any feedback from Dr. V on this?
Yeah, I'm having a conversation with Dr. V. I mean, Shirley Spork is one of the founding members of the LPGA, and she recognized Yar, and the feedback from her has been just phenomenal in her experiences with the Yar. And so it's just a matter of time that when we have more presence on the bigger tours, the PGA Tour, the LPGA Tour, that when players are using this in tournament competition, it's just going to be an eye-opening of what a putter through science and engineering can actually do. It's not about hype. It's about true science and about result.
Okay, we're going to take a break and come back, talk about how this putter holds the line, the MOI, which is, you say, near perfect, and how stable it is. My name is Danielle Tucker, and this is The Golf Club.
Now, back to Danielle Tucker on The Golf Club.
If you'd like to find out more about the Yar putter, you can always go to yargolf.com. Yargolf.com is where you can find out more about this particular putter that we're talking about. In one of the YouTube clips that I was looking at, face balanced putter myth versus results, Robbie Camacho was talking about this. Now, that's what I was getting at earlier, the face balanced putter myth, that when you come back, when you bring the club back and come to the ball, that with the Yar, it doesn't have that twisting action. Right, Robbie?
Right, correct. There is no twisting action. Again, moment of inertia related to golf, in this case we're talking about putters, is the ability of the putter to stay stable when motion is applied. So, with any other putter, what I'd recommend the listener to do, and you don't have to be at the golf course, you can do it in your home. You don't need
a
golf ball.
Go get a putter.
You can do this right now. Go get your putter.
Yeah.
And here's what you do. With your existing putter, and you don't need a ball to do this, swing your putter back and forward like you normally do. Feel the weight, feel the completeness of the putter as you swing it. Then configure the putter to where you feel it's the lightest. And what you'll find, 99% of the time, you'll find that when you swing it with the heel leading, that's when you'll notice and feel that it's smooth, easy to repeat, and the feeling of being very light with the heel leading.
Interesting. That's certainly not the way you want to come in contact with your golf ball.
Well, right, yeah, you won't be able to putt that way very effectively with a heel leading.
No. So what you're saying is the Yar putter doesn't do that. It'll explain.
Well, with the Yar putter being very stable with near-perfect moment of inertia, it's a matter of when you swing the putter, and we're not advocating any type of particular technique. We're talking about just swinging it back and forward, that putter will return to the ball based on how the face was looking at prior to contact.
And it'll roll beautifully.
It will roll beautifully, end over end, like everyone wants to see, where the ball hugs the ground, and will track to your target. So when people end the swing on their finish, when they hold the face, they'll see exactly, well, here's my face, it's at my target, the end result is it rolled towards the target.
That's great. You make custom clubs for people, and you can get fitted online, by the way, at yargolf.com, and then everybody has their own handle. Let's say you want to say, my name is Freddie Mac, and you want Freddie Mac to be on your club. You have a faceplate that you'll put on, right, for people?
Oh, absolutely. So if someone wanted to have their first name, last name, or any type of nickname, that can certainly be arranged and placed right on the putter.
Yeah, that Shirley's fork has a really cute handle, which is going to be on her faceplate. I thought that was great. Golf Test USA. Have you ever heard about them? Golf Test USA. They're America's golf testing company, they say. And if you'd like to go to their website, you can actually enter there to win a Yar GX1 putter, okay? And what they did is they took a number of different putters and they tested them. Interesting results for the Yar putter based on a number of different categories. The distance control, alignment, the accuracy, forgiveness, the sound, so critical. I mean, people say, sound? You know, if you don't like the sound of the ball striking, it's going to affect how you play, even though the sound happens after you've hit the ball. Doesn't make any sense, does it? No, but it's all about how it looks, right? When you look down on your putter from above and you look down, you go, oh, yeah, no, it doesn't look right. That's another key thing. You know, that's why there's so many putters for so many different personalities, because we all have our different likes. The appearance, the feel, the design. This particular putter got like 5 stars across the board. You must be really proud.
Oh, well, very proud. Very proud to be associated with Yar and a fitter. And no, I'm a fitter. I mean, I have it in my bag, and it's been, personally, I can say that it's been the best putter I've ever owned. I've shot one of my lowest scores by having the putter. I shot a 66 with the Yar in my bag, and it was just a phenomenal day.
Okay. You've just recently fitted one of the LPGA players. Who was that? Was that at the Founders Cup or at Kraft?
That was at the Founders Cup. Her name is Kayoung Bae. She's an up-and-coming player on the LPGA Tour. And so, you know, the hopes are that she'll be able to use that during tournament play. And she's got one of our putters. So hopefully we'll see, cross her fingers, that she'll do well with it when she puts it in play.
And Dad? Dad got fitted too?
Actually, Dad got fitted. Her dad
was
on the putting green. So he has a Yar. And so hopefully he'll
Great.
Be using it and start to spread the word about the Yar.
Excellent. All right, and that's the Yar putter, something for you to consider. Again, it's ergonomically designed so that if you have a physical challenge, you don't have to bend over. And, you know, if your hips hurt, your knees hurt, you can just literally put that club right over the ball, and it has a little hinge. It'll lift it up for you. You don't have to bend over. That's the great part. It's in the cup. You can just bring it right out with your Yar putter. It's light, has a wonderful, wonderful feel to it, swings true, comes back. It's a very, very nice club. Thanks so much, Robbie, for being on the show.
Thank you, Danielle. Thanks for having me.
Is there anything you'd like to add that I didn't give you a chance to?
You did a great job. You know the putter well. You know just as much as I do. But, yeah, one point I wanted to make, and you mentioned about how people that may have physical challenges, one of the benefits, too, where if one has, you know, let's say one arm, you can, and even if you have two hands and arms, I mean, you can putt effectively very well with just one hand on the instrument.
You, I've worked with the military as well. I noticed that you guys went to Iraq?
Right, right. Yar had a representative out there in Iraq with the soldiers and did some great fittings with some of the soldiers back in Iraq.
Thank you. My son, yes. Okay, enough said on that. He hates it when I talk about him on the show. Okay, from Yar Putters, Robbie Camacho, thanks for being on the show. Say hi to Dr. V for me, and I'm looking forward to hearing the results. We have some news, possibly. One of the very well-known players on the LPGA Tour just may be playing with a Yar Putter in the future. We'll see. Okay, Robbie, thanks.
Thank you.
We're going to get back.